Hello friends, my name is Deepak Sharma and today we are discussing about the multi-degree of freedom system, eigenvalues and eigenvector of it because it is an important part of mechanical vibration. So first we discuss about its introduction. A multi-degree of freedom system is one which requires two or more coordinates to describe its motion. These coordinates are called generalized coordinates when they are independent of each other and equal in number to the degrees of freedom of the system. The procedure of analyzing a multi-degree of freedom system is only an extension of the methods used for analyzing two degrees of freedom systems. The use of influence coefficients and writing the equations in matrix forms makes the things sufficiently simpler. Now, first we discuss about the multi-degree of freedom system equation of motion. For this, consider an undamped system as shown in the figure having n degrees of freedom. The figure shows that there are m1, m2, m3 and mn. There are n masses are continuously attached to each other by the springs. K whose stiffness are K1, K2, K3 and Kn. Now write down the differential equation for each mass separately from the Newton's second law as shown in the figure. Let x1, x2, x3 and xn are the displacement from the equilibrium position of the respective masses at that instant. Then the motion of equations are shown by the equation first, like m1 x1 double dot plus k1 k2 x1 plus k2 x2 minus is equals to 0 and so others. These equations are the equation of motion for each and every systems. The above equations are required equations of motions which can also be written in the matrix forms. And if we return in the matrix forms, then this is shown in the equation number second, or in short it by the equation number third, where m is the square matrix of nth order and with only diagonal elements in this case as shown in the equation number second. K is the square stiffness matrix also of order n, this matrix being a symmetrical one as shown in again equation number 2. X is a column matrix of n elements corresponding to the dynamic displacement of the respective n masses. Now the equation third is very similar to the following equation, which is a equation for single degree of freedom. Now friends, now we are going to discuss about the natural frequencies and mod shapes, or we can say that eigenvalues or eigenvectors. Let us take for understanding the eigenvalue and eigenvector, let us take a multi-degree of freedom system given in the figure 1 for generalizing the method or for determining its natural frequencies and mod shapes. The differential equation of motion for the system are shown by the equation number 1. For the principal mode of vibration, let us assume that the solutions are following, which is shown in the equation number 2. Now, if we put the values of x1, x2, x3 and xn from equation 2 to equation 1 and cancel out the common terms sin omega t, then we get the final equation which is shown in the equation by equation 3. Now for the above equation, the solution other than x1 is equals to, x2 is equals to, xn is equals to 0 is possible only when the determinant composed of the coefficient x dash vanishes, or we can say that the equation third is converted in the form of equation 4. This is the frequency equation being nth degree of omega square and therefore gives n values of omega square corresponding to n natural frequencies. The mode shape can be obtained from equation 3 by using it at one at a time. The various values of omega as obtained from equation number 4. Now, B part. In this part, we discuss about the eigenvector. In the matrix forms, the differential equation of motion for the system, in fact for any system, can be written as following, which is shown in equation number 5. That means matrix M is x double dot plus k matrix k into x is equals to 0. Now, pre-multiplying the above equation by inverse M matrix, then we get get the values which is shown in the equation number 6, where M inverse or M is equals to I, which is a unit matrix, and M inverse K is equals to D, a dynamic matrix, as shown in the equation number 7 and 8. For free body vibration, assuming harmonic motion of frequency omega, that means x is equals to x sine omega t, as shown in equation number 9. If we have x double dot is equals to minus omega square x, and which is equal to minus lambda x. Now put the value of x in this equation, then the equation becomes minus lambda x sine omega t, as shown in the equation number 9a, where lambda is equals to so we can say that lambda is equals to omega square, which is the eigenvalue, and x is the column giving the amplitudes of respective masses, or we can say that is eigenvectors. And equation 6, with the help of equation 9 and 9a, becomes converted in the another form, which is shown in the equation number 10. The determinant formed from the above equation, as shown by equation number 11, is the frequency equation and gives n values of lambda for n degrees of freedom. By substituting lambda I in the matrix equation 10, we obtain the mod shape called the eigenvector for the ith mode of vibration. Thus, n degrees of freedom system will give n eigenvalues and corresponding n eigenvectors. Thank you.